Hello, I'm Johara Singaporensis, a Singapore freshwater crab, but you can just call me Joe. And I want to tell you about some magical forests called mangroves. In this video, I'll explain what mangroves are and why they're absolutely marvelous. This is my friend, Max the mangrove tree. Max lives in a mangrove forest with lots of other plants and wildlife. Mangroves mainly grow along tropical coasts, in areas where fresh water mixes with salt water. They experience high and low tides, and their soils are soft, muddy, and low in oxygen. These are very harsh conditions, where most other trees would simply wither away, but mangroves like Max are tough. They've adapted to survive and thrive in very clever ways. And the roots of their success are in their roots. Many mangroves have special root networks above and below ground. Buttress roots and stilt roots, for example, are very big and extend from the trunks, giving stability in the soft, muddy soil and stopping mangrove trees like Max from falling over. Others, such as pencil roots and knee roots, grow upwards or in loops, projecting up from the soil and help the mangroves breathe, even when submerged in tidal waters. These roots, called pneumatophores, are covered with pores called lenticels. Lenticels repel water, stop it from flooding into the roots, and help the mangroves get oxygen from the air above the water. A bit like a snorkel for Max the mangrove. And too much salt water can be harmful to trees. So some mangroves get rid of excess salt by secreting it through special pores or salt glands in their leaves. They've adapted to the salty conditions so successfully that they can survive in soil with twice the level of salinity of the ocean. That's super salty! We now know how Max and the mangroves can survive in such difficult conditions. But how can they reproduce and make more mangroves? In other words, what about mini Max? The seeds of most plants and trees remain dormant after pollination until dispersed by wind or insects to a suitable place where they start germinating and growing into seedlings. But this doesn't work for mangroves. Mini Max seedlings, officially called propagules, start germinating and growing immediately after pollination, while still attached to their parent trees. After a while, the propagules fall into the water and are carried away by currents. They float about for a number of days until they become waterlogged, sink to the muddy bottom, anchor in the soil, and start growing. And making more or maximizing mangroves has never been more urgent. Indonesia is home to the largest area of mangroves in the world. The country has 1/5 of the Earth's mangroves, covering a massive 3 million hectares. But sadly, due to development, land reclamation, and industrialization in the past 30 years, the country has lost 40% of its mangrove forests. For similar reasons, Singapore's mangroves have also dramatically declined. 200 years ago, 13% of our coastline and riverbanks were covered with mangroves. But today, less than 5% of those original mangroves remain. If we don't take greater care of our mangroves, then Max the mangrove tree might become as endangered as me. That would be a tragedy. Because even though mangroves cover a tiny fraction of the Earth's surface, they do so much for all life on the planet. Not only are they an invaluable ecosystem, but mangroves absorb huge amounts of climate-warming carbon. Just 1 square kilometer of mangroves can absorb and store as much carbon as the annual emissions of 45,000 cars. Mangrove root systems also absorb the impact of waves, protecting coastal areas from storms and rising seas. They trap soil and sediment, absorb nutrients, and stop them washing away downstream, leading to better water quality in coral reefs and seagrass beds. There's no doubt about it, mangroves like Max really are marvelous and need to be respected and protected. I'll be telling you more about them in the rest of the series. But in the meantime, let's all Max the mangroves!